G'day, smart person. My name's Dylan. I'm a physicist. And today we're going to be reacting to another episode of Rick and Morty. So the first episode I did was A Wrinkle in Time, I believe it's called. And it had so much great physics in it. I really enjoyed it. And it's been getting a pretty good response. Lots of people are requesting I do more. There are some negative comments, of course, but we'll ignore that. So I've pulled up another episode. Some lovely person in the comments suggested another episode of Rick and Morty. So today we're watching season 1, episode 10, I believe, and it's called Close Rick Counters of the Rick Kind. So that's obviously a reference to Close Encounters of the Third Kind, the Steven Spielberg film. And if you haven't seen that, masterpiece. So go check that out. So a lot of people were saying, Dylan, you don't need to wear a suit and tie in a bedroom. So here we are out in the lounge room. Hopefully I get a lot less negative comments. I'm going to be reacting to a bunch of Rick and Morty episodes, possibly even all of them. So if you want to catch those, definitely subscribe and like this video so it gets it out to other fans of the show and other geeks and nerds like us. So let's watch.
Is your 1 year anniversary back in our lives? I'm going to make you flying saucer-shaped pancakes.
Oh, there's a reference to Close Encounters. So I'm guessing this is the multiverse, right? So you've got another version of Rick and Morty here, seemingly looking a bit different. So in the multiverse theory, there's a whole bunch of universes out there, right? And everything that's possible within the laws of physics is happening out there. So, and you know, the laws of physics might be different elsewhere. I'm wanting to go on a tangent right now, but I'm trying my best not to. I only just noticed that this Rick is called C137. Fine structure constant, which is a very, very mysterious number in physics. It's got this weird value, 1 over 137. That's a very strange number. If you want to go look into that, it's hella mysterious. And it's essentially the strength of electromagnetism. I didn't say the fine structure constant is essentially a ratio of some of the constants of nature, like Planck's constant, the speed of light, and some other things. So I guess what they're getting at is this Rick is from the universe where the fine structure constant, the constant for C, is 137. 1 over 137, that's pretty cool. So in the multiverse, what you essentially have are these isolated universes, so to speak. There's, you know, so far that you would never be able to travel there because they're essentially expanding away from us faster than the speed of light. And there's also another interpretation of the multiverse, and that's from the many worlds interpretation of quantum mechanics, which suggests that reality branches off every time there's a quantum measurement. Explained that in the last Rick and Morty one. So go and watch that if you want a bit more on that. If you already have watched it, you might understand what I'm talking about. And in that view of the multiverse, they're completely isolated places and you can't really get to them. And this is all very theoretical. This is not, you know, real stuff. It could be, but we have no idea whether or not any of this is true. So don't take what I'm saying like gospel, like it's probably not true. And so, if you have these other universes out there which have a slightly different constants of nature, like the speed of light or the fine structure constant, well, you're going to get a very different universe, possibly one with nothing in it. And so this argument is what leads to the fine tuning of the universe. We seem to be in this place where if you tune the constants just a little bit, the whole thing doesn't work. So that is very mysterious. Let's get back to the show. So seemingly, Rick and Morty from another universe from the multiverse have showed up through a portal. And yeah, let's see what they're up to.
Regular pancakes are already shaped like flying saucers. I should be making you breakfast for putting up with me.
Should be making us a whole restaurant.
Nonsense. Couldn't be happier to have you around. I just wish I got to see more of you.
Rick Sanchez, relatable. Earth Dimension C-137. You are under arrest for crimes against alternate Ricks by the authority of the Transdimensional Council of Ricks.
Hey!
Wow.
Neutralize the cherry.
Got fans out there. So let me just expand on this multiverse just a little bit. So if you haven't thought about it that deeply before, there is a multiverse out there. It essentially means there's other yous out there. And not just other yous, an infinite number of other yous. Could be a universe out there where you're Harry Potter. I'm kidding. It's only, you know, things have to be allowed by the laws of physics, right? And as far as I can tell, magic isn't really allowable. But, you know, superiorly advanced technology is indistinguishable from magic. So I want to bring up this cool story, and it comes from the name of The Infinite Monkey Cage, which is Brian Cox's podcast or TV show or whatever. And the name, Infinite Monkey Cage, right? It's sort of a reference to the multiverse. So you have these infinite universes, the monkey cage, because we're all primates, right? Smart primates for the OGs out there. What that means is there's a monkey out there, an ape, a primate, and if you sit it, if it sat in front of a typewriter, it would randomly punch on the different keys, right? All the different letters. And it would be nonsense. It'd be random, right? But if you did that an infinite amount of times in the multiverse, there will be one place out there where that monkey has accidentally, by, you know, punching around, has letter for letter, character for character, typed out the play of Hamlet, Shakespeare's play. And so that's where that name comes from, the infinite monkey cage. And that's what the multiverse means. By random coincidence, there's going to be a monkey out there that gets to the very last character and gets it wrong. But anyway, let's keep watching. I think you get the idea, right? So
most Ricks have a Morty. This place is a real who's who of who's you and me. Turn your boring old Morty into a hot fashion statement with some Morty dazzlers. Hey, check this out. Show me the Morty. Excuse me, sir. Is your Morty in their own timelines? An unprecedented ricocidal epidemic. What say you, Earth Rick C-137? You think I did this? Why am I the first Rick you pulled in every time you have us question? You fit the profile. Of all the Ricks in the central finite curve, you're the malcontent, the rogue. I'm the Rick, and so were the rest of you before you formed this stupid...
That doesn't make a lot of sense. If there's a multiverse, like I've been explaining, there'd be an infinite number of them. A finite curve? No, infinite curve. So, I'm not sure what they were getting at with that, the Rick that was formerly a scientist. Maybe there's something I have missed in previous episodes.
Yeah, I'd like to order one large person with extra people, please.
White people. No. Black people. And Hispanic on half.
So there's not too much physics going on, but there's a lot of portals. And if you want to learn a little tiny bit about wormholes, go and watch my previous video, Interstellar Explained, because I essentially talk about wormholes and what they are and whether or not something like this could be possible. So I thought I'd just plug myself.
They'll be onto us.
Phones a la clams and phone steady with phone balls. Anything else?
Yeah, more phone sticks, please.
Right away, sir.
You know, Rick, when I first saw all those Ricks and Mortys, I thought, gee, that kind of devalues our bond. But then I realized it just means that our relationship must be pretty special to span over all those different timelines.
So all this stuff where, you know, there are people for chairs and chairs for people, it's not exactly realistic. I know we're just watching a cartoon and you know, we're not meant to take this stuff seriously, I get it. But I'm going to be doing that anyway, because that's what I'm making these videos for. To sort of break down if any of this is realistic, right? I get that it's just entertainment, and it is entertaining. But are there multiverses out there where people are chairs and chairs are people? No, because it has to be allowable by the laws of physics. And, you know, humans arose to be the apex predator thanks to many things. But one of those things is natural selection. And I don't think natural selection would allow chairs to... It doesn't really make any sense, does it? So is there a multiverse out there where a chair has consciousness? Well, I don't think so, but could be wrong.
Yeah, it's gotta be that way. You're a camouflage.
Camouflage? What, What are you talking about, Rick?
Ricks have a very distinctive and traceable brainwave due to our genius. The best way to hide from an enemy's radar is to stand near someone with complementary brainwaves that make ours invisible. See, when a Rick is with a Morty, the genius waves get canceled out by the, Morty waves.
Because our personalities are so different?
Oh, shit, dog! My portal gun was hacked from...
That's fantastic. Could you really create something to detect brainwaves? Of course you could, because what are brainwaves? Just normal electromagnetic waves, like everything else. So, of course you could do that. There's nothing weird coming out of the brain in terms of physics. It's all the same stuff that makes up these chairs. You know, in saying that, I should say we don't really know what consciousness is, but it's clear there's nothing strange going on there. It's just normal physics stuff. And I love what he said about Morty being close to him sort of interferes with his brain waves, his genius waves, whatever they are. But obviously that's not a real thing. But, you know, he's getting at this principle of constructive and destructive interference. And that's a real thing. A really awesome example is the double slit experiment. So YouTube that if you want to have your mind blown, because it is awesome. I'm just going to keep watching here. I've done enough tangents for this video already, so let's focus.
Earthrick C-137, the council apologizes for its false accusation. And in the way of reparations for our terrible mistake, we would like to compensate you with this voucher for a free replacement Morty in the event that your current Morty shot, guys.
So I think I'll leave it there. That'll do for this episode. I enjoyed it. It was really funny. Wasn't as much physics in this one, but there's lots of humor. So once again, if you haven't subscribed already, please apply some time derivative of momentum and hit that subscribe button. Yeah, I'll see you next time, guys. Catch ya.